Breath of the Freaking Wild 2. Yes, folks, we're talking about this sequel to Breath of the Wild today, as we have a bit of an update, kind of, sort of, on the game. It comes from one of the most heralded and reliable Nintendo leakers, maybe of all time, in Emily Rogers. But before we get into that, I want to remind you to enter our giveaway for Final Fantasy Crystal Chronicles Remastered Edition. To enter, all you need to do is comment on this video, like this video, subscribe to the channel, and hit that bell icon that gets you one entry. You can do that on every video this month. Winner will be announced at the end of the month. Also, if we get to 50,000 subscribers by November 1st of 2020, we will be giving away an Xbox Series X, a PlayStation 5, or a Nintendo Switch to one lucky winner. Now, let's get into this. So, I've been talking for quite some time about kind of a, we could say it's a prediction, but it was more of a hope that Breath of the Wild 2, the sequel, would be coming this year. I felt like it made perfect sense for it to be the game that goes toe-to-toe with the next-gen platforms in PlayStation 5 and Xbox Series X. It's a game that ensures Switch cannot be ignored. However, it does look like the momentum of Switch is so great right now that Switch will not be ignored this holiday, even if there isn't a major game, which I feel like there still will be. It's just not going to be Zelda. And obviously, we have the update with the potential Nintendo Switch Pro coming out early next year, possibly even launching with Breath of the Wild, the sequel. Get into that speculation in a bit. But we actually have somebody who is way more in the know than me, than you, than probably any of us that don't work at Nintendo. And Emily Rogers put up a tweet. She was talking about responding to a tweet earlier this year, talking about expectations for this year. And this is where, like, I found out that Pikmin 3 Deluxe was actually supposed to be like an April, May game and was pushed back to October. If it had released back then, obviously it would have been an even more jam-packed first half of the year. But obviously with E3 likely being canceled, the pandemic hitting, and obviously possibly having to delay a game or two out of 2021, they wanted to push Pikmin 3 Deluxe to the second half, out towards October, so they could, you know, have more games coming out during this period. Chances are there's some sort of game that was going to come out this year delayed into 2021, and we're not talking about Breath of the Wild 2, because she responded to a comment asking about Breath of the Wild 2, and she basically said that Breath of the Wild 2 was never coming this year. That was never going to be a game coming out this year. So, yeah. What does that mean? What can we infer from that? Well, beyond the fact that this all but confirms that Breath of the Wild 2, even though Breath of the Wild 2 wasn't even announced for this year, is not going to come in 2020, I think this also solidifies 2021, because earlier this year she talked about being a great year if you were a plumber, lots of remasters and ports and all that. See, the reason it would be a great year to be a plumber is it was the 35th anniversary of Mario, and obviously there's going to be a bunch of Mario stuff. Now, granted, we haven't actually gotten a bunch of Mario stuff. We've gotten Paper Mario, and that's it. The rest of the Mario stuff is just rumored. We don't actually know that it's coming, but if that stuff lands, as the rumors and the leakers are saying it's going to, well, that should mean that next year, the Year of Zelda, would actually make a lot of sense to have a bunch of Zelda games come out, along with Breath of the Wild 2. Now, you might naturally assume that Breath of the Wild 2 should be the holiday game next year to cap the year, and that very well may be the case. However, if they're going to launch new hardware earlier in the year, it might make sense to launch Breath of the Wild 2 alongside of that new hardware the way they launched it aside Switch in 2017. Now, this doesn't mean that it wouldn't be a Switch exclusive game, that it wouldn't play on those OG Switches from 2017. Of course it would. The Switch Pro is not a replacement, it's just an upgrade if it does exist, and it would be really cool to see the Switch Pro come out on March 3rd, which is the same day the Switch released and Breath of the Wild released, you know, 3 years prior, so or 4 years prior at that point. So it would be really, really cool to see that happen, and I'm kind of rooting for that to be the case. But even if that's not the case, and it is the capper game, I think that next year being the 35th anniversary of Zelda, just like this year was the 35th anniversary of Mario, we're talking about the Japan release, not the North American release. So that you have that. You have the Skyward Sword HD rumor, which also kind of coincides with another rumor that Twilight Princess HD and Wind Waker HD are coming as well. All of those could be packed into next year. And then, yeah, Breath of the Wild Freaking 2. The sequel, whatever they decide to call it. They might not even use the Breath of the Wild name. I have no idea. Whatever it is called, The Legend of Zelda blank, is likely going to be a 35th anniversary game. And maybe it was always planned to be a 35th anniversary release, even though it was revealed last year. Now, I do think Nintendo might show Breath of the Wild 2 this year, especially if we're talking about a spring release coming alongside a new Switch Pro. So we very well could see Breath of the Wild 2 very, very soon. Maybe in the supposed Direct this week, if not, you know, later on in the year. So I'm not going to rule out a seeing Breath of the Wild 2 this year. That could be a thing. But it's obviously not coming this year. Emily Rogers has a great track record. And yeah, you can basically look towards 2021 as when Zelda Breath of the Wild 2 is going to be arriving, whether it's early or later in the year. What's also true about Zelda games is they don't need a holiday period to sell well. Breath of the Wild 2 obviously proved that. Unique case in launching a platform. But then again, if it's launching the Switch Pro, hey, they just repeated that unique case. Kind of, sort of. It's not a new generation. But yeah, I'm curious, though, when do you guys think Breath of the Wild 2 is going to come out? I realize the holiday speculation for this year was always kind of a pipe dream. I made my arguments for it earlier this year, but I kind of always knew in the back of my mind that, you know, I'm just getting my hopes up and getting some wishful thinking going. There was no indication from Nintendo that it was ever going to be coming this year. But yeah, let's get Breath of the Wild 2 in the second half, shall we? Anyways, I want to thank you guys for tuning in. I love any time we could talk about Zelda, even though it's not a very intricate conversation, because we can't really have intricate conversation. I think everything there is to possibly say about that reveal trailer has already been said. So at this point, people will just be reaching for straws to keep talking about it. We need to at least see it. And I'll say this, I firmly believe we will see Breath of the Wild 2 before the end of the year in terms of a trailer. But we're not going to see the game until next year. So take that for what you will. Anyways, folks, I am Nathaniel Rubble Jans from Nintendo Prime. Thank you for tuning in, and I will catch you in the next video.